So one of the most common questions I get from salespeople is, how do I follow up with prospects after a meeting or a demo? The meeting will go great, but after the demo, they'll ghost. The truth is, if you're following up with a prospect, you've already lost. You might as well tell the prospect, you know what? Actually, don't buy this product. You'll get the same result. And in this video, I'm gonna tell you why and give you a strategy that eliminates your need for following up altogether. After I learned the strategy, it helped me quadruple my close rate, which helped me make more money, which helped me eat better food and become ripped. And it's gonna do the same for you. So let's start by talking about what most salespeople do. First, we'll get prospects on a call, discover pain points, build rapport, tackle objections, pitch the product, and try to go for the close. Naturally, there will be times where a prospect won't give you a yes right away. Maybe they need to talk to their business partner or spouse. Maybe they need to figure out how to pay for your product or service. What most salespeople do is say they'll check in on the prospect after a certain amount of time. A couple days go by and they'll try to give the prospect a call. The prospect doesn't pick up, so the salesperson leaves a voicemail message. Hey there, just following up and seeing if you had the time to get the green light on the proposal. Give me a call back. Hours go by, then days, then a week, no response. They've ghosted you, and now you cry yourself to sleep. The problem with this approach is that you're keeping things way too open-ended. By telling them that you'll follow up and leaving it at that, you're keeping things too abstract for your prospects, and it feels less real. As a result, it's way less likely they'll take the action steps necessary for the deal to close. It's kind of like when you run into someone you know on the street and you're like, hey, we should hang out sometime. They might agree at face value, but if it's left at that, chances are that you won't meet up ever. Which can be good if deep down you're not actually trying to hang out with them, but this is horrible for sales. So how do we get around this? Well, the answer is to set clear and meaningful next steps. One, once you get their agreement, tell them the steps that you need to take, if any, prior to the next meeting. Maybe you need to send over some case studies or put together a proposal. Two, ask them explicitly what steps they need to take before your next meeting. Perhaps they need to speak to their boss tomorrow to get approval. Maybe they need to submit your terms to the legal department. Whatever it is, by having them say it out loud, it will give them clarity on exactly what they need to do in order for the deal to go through on their end. Three, get their commitment for the next meeting. Ask them if they're available for a specific time and date and make sure they're legitimately on board for this next meeting. Once you do these three things, you won't need to follow up anymore. They have clear expectations and know exactly what to do on their end. As a result of this clarity, they'll be way more likely to take action and purchase your service. Once this happens, your close rate will increase and you'll start making a lot more money. Your new life's problems will be choosing what color Lamborghini you want. Thanks for watching. If you want to go deeper into accelerating your B2B sales skills, I made a free 17-minute video training about the three most game-changing strategies that will help you exceed your sales goals by 150%. I've helped salespeople all over the country see awesome results, and I want you to be next. Click the link below to sign up, and I'll see you inside.